Hi everyone, welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. This is part one of a two-part series. We're going to look at some different ways to export data via email in Scriptcase. This first video is going to deal with the two built-in ways with PDF and XLS. And so there's three supported APIs, SMTP, Amazon SES, and Mandrill. We're going to look at SMTP and Amazon SES mostly today. We're going to focus on SMTP, but we'll also look at how to set up Amazon SES. So here's an example application that is included with the samples program, samples project in Scriptcase. So as you can see here, we have some settings for an email. We have an HTML editor for the body. And then over on the settings tab, we can choose our API gateway, SMTP, Mandrill, and Amazon. We can set our server, SMTP port. These are all the settings for SMTP. And so there's all those settings there. So here is the Mandrill website. You can go ahead and sign up for an account here. You have to pay for this if you want to use it. And then over here, we have the Amazon AWS console here. The simple email service is what SES stands for. So you can sign up for that. And then you can access your API key, et cetera, that you need to enter into Scriptcase. Okay, so here we are back at this application. So if I change this API to one of these, the Mandrill here, you see the API key, which you would get from Mandrill, and the Amazon SES, you'd see the API key, the secret key, and the region. Those are the three pieces of information you need for that. So we can do this here as an example, but for now, we're going to set up an application to do this ourselves. So you can do this all with API profiles inside of Scriptcase. So here we have a grid application. This is the grid we're going to be using to export from. We can group by on this grid. We have a group by on here right now. We can take that off, right, like so, by clicking the group by option here. And then we can export to a PDF here. This is going to go directly to the server. We're going to add an option to export to an email instead of directly to the browser. So here is our grid application. And if we go to export here, and then we have our export types, those are all of our old types there that are supported. And then we can go to email here to set up our email settings for exporting. So as you can see here, we have an API option, and that's what we need to set up before we can send anything. So you can set up a custom one here, and you could just enter in all the information right here. But if you wanted to use this in multiple applications, it might be good to set up an API profile here. So you can click the edit button, or you can go up to tools, API, right like so. So if I click on that, it's going to come around and load a screen for us to set up an API profile. So I've got a few set up here. You can ignore those for now. I'm going to click add new to add a new one so I can show you how to do it. You can name it whatever you want. It just has to be unique. So I'm going to call it Gmail since I'm using Gmail. And I'm going to leave it to public, and it's going to be an SMTP type. And so now I'm going to set my server. So you need to get this from your email service if you're using Gmail or something else. And make sure you get all the security settings set up, especially if you're using Gmail. There's a few hoops you need to jump through to set up an application password and so forth. We're going to use SSL protocol, and then the from email. This can be what it's going to show as from. So I'm going to make it my email address, necarpenter@gmail.com. And then the from name, going to be my name, Nate Carpenter. So now make sure you set the port 465. That's for SSL on Gmail. And then go ahead and hit save on that. And as you can see, it's got the green check mark by it, which means it is ready to go for this project. So now back here, we can go ahead and reload our dropdown here. And there is our Gmail option, right like so. Then you can set up your export settings. So the default to address is going to be my email again. You can make this whatever you want, or you can leave it blank. You'll be able to enter it when you choose to export it off the grid. So you can set up some settings for copies, the default title for the email, and the default body for the email. And you can leave those blank or make them whatever you want. And then you can again change them at runtime as well. Now we need to add some options to our toolbar here. It's giving us a message that it's not going to be on there until we add it. So we need to go to the toolbar option, make sure we save everything, wait for that to load here. And we're going to see some options here. So as you can see, we have a desktop and a mobile toolbar option. And this left menu here is all the options we have available. And the right menu is going to be everything that's on the toolbar. So there's our export options right there. We're going to go ahead and add them below the regular exports so that we have our email exports after our browser exports. So I'm going to do PDF, and I'm going to do Excel. Those are our two types, and it's going to work and be set up for both of them. We don't need to set up a separate email settings here. And then we're going to add a button group. So that's going to group them together like the current export button. So we can label that whatever we want. We can display some different settings here. So lots of different things here. We're going to keep it pretty simple. Just put a title on it, click add, and then make sure both of those options are underneath that group. So I'm going to bump in PDF underneath that. So that's going to group those buttons together and make them look a little bit nicer and not take up as much space on the toolbar. So we can go ahead and run this now. Wait for this to come around and load, and we should see our options for exporting emails. And as you can see, yes, we do. There's an email export option. Let's go ahead and take this group by off before we test it. Keep it basic for the first test run, and then we can add the group by back on to see what that does for us. So now we go up here. I'm going to email a PDF right now. So let's go ahead and click PDF. It's going to pop up in modal here. And there we go. There's our PDF settings. We can take the columns off. I'm going to take some of those off there and then go ahead and click OK on that. And here's our email settings. So there's that to address and the subject and the body. We can change those if we want. I'm going to leave them and just click send email. It's sent successfully. So now let's see if that email is in our inbox. So let me go over there, and here's that email that was sent, right, like so. As you can see, it looks like it was from me. That's because it's using SMTP, and there's the attachment. I can click on that, and there we go. There's our report. So just a very basic report, and as with anything in Scriptcase, you can modify which fields and columns are on there and edit some spacing as well if you want. So that's just a very basic option. Now let's do an Excel export. So back here at the grid, let's go to email export in Excel. So this is going to generate an Excel spreadsheet. So again, which type of Excel, XLS or XLSX, whichever is best for your use cases. The columns, again, you can select those and then click OK. Then it's going to give us our email settings, same as before, same settings. We can change those if we want, but we're just going to send the email now. Go ahead and click send. Email sent successfully. And then we can go over and see that email in our inbox. Here it is. Looks just the same as before, except this time it has a spreadsheet attached. I can go ahead and open that in Google Drive here, or you could download it and open it in Excel if you wanted to. But there is our spreadsheet. Looks very nice, looks very easy to use, and is in our inbox ready to go. So now let's add a group by on this so we can group by some different data here. And that's going to go ahead and go through on our PDF report as well. So let's add our group by on. So this is grouped by the year of hire date. This is kind of an HR table of all the employees. So we're grouping by hire date here, and you can kind of see it on screen here. You can't see all the data, of course, but you can see we're grouping by that year. So now we're going to email a PDF to ourselves again, get all the columns and settings all set up. We're going to leave that as is for now. We could take columns on and off, just like before. Go ahead and click OK. Set our email settings if we wanted to add anyone or modify the message or subject. Go ahead and click send. It was sent successfully. Now let's see if this PDF shows all the records grouped by year of hire date. So let's go over to my email here. And there it is, same as before. Let's go ahead and open this PDF here to see what it says. And as you can see, just like you saw on the grid, it's grouping by the year of hire date. So you're seeing some different years here, 1959, etc. So that those filters and group bys that we apply to the grid are going to come through in this PDF, which is really useful, really easy to use. Now let's do Amazon. So this is the same way. We're going to set up an API here, and then we just need to set that API on the grid, and it'll be ready to go. So add new again, naming it Amazon. It's going to be public again. And instead of SMTP, it's going to be Amazon SES. All right, so we can get our credentials here at the Amazon AWS console. So here's the page for the SES service, but we're going to go ahead and sign into the console here up in the top right. Go ahead and wait for that to load. So you're going to need an Amazon developer account. I already have one, and you can find the SES service here on this page. But to get our credentials, we need to go up to the top again to our name and go ahead and go to My Security Credentials right there. Wait for that to load. And here we have different credentials for our account. We need the Access Keys tab here. Expand that. There's the credentials I already have created. You might not have those, but if you don't, you can click Create New Access Key. Then you can download a CSV file with them all there, and you can see them. So if I click download there, I can download the file to my computer to always have it. Otherwise, I can click expand here and get them for the one-time use right there. But after that, you're not going to be able to access your secret key. And you're going to need that region there, as well as the access key and the secret key. If I go back to the main area, you can find your region here at the top. See where it says North Virginia, which is where my server is. Click US East 1. That is that code for that region, which is what you're going to need to go over and add the API in Scriptcase. We need our key, so you get that from the Amazon AWS console. And then the secret and also the region. So let me copy in the region here. Let me copy in the rest of my information here. So you got the API key right here. Let me go ahead and grab that and copy it in. And let me make sure I have it. There we go. And then the secret API key. Let me grab that one and copy it in here. So you can export these and download them from the AWS console. And then you can have them for whenever you need them. Go ahead and set the from email, same as before, and the from name, same as before. So now we can go ahead and click save on that, and it should be ready to go, and we can send an email using Amazon. So let me go ahead and get out of that. Let's go over to our grid now, and it's got the green check mark next to it, so we can use it on this project. Change our API profile. Let's reload it here, and then change it to our Amazon SES one, right like so. That's the one we just set up. We can go ahead and save that, and now we don't need to do anything else. We can go ahead and run this, and it should work just like before, except now it's sending from Amazon. So that's saving you a lot of coding, a lot of programming to integrate all those APIs. Scriptcase does it automatically. So let's do an Excel spreadsheet for now, and we can change our settings just like before, and then go ahead and click OK, and then send the email. Email was sent. So now let's go over to my Gmail account and see if we can find that email. As you can see, because this isn't fully set up for production, we're seeing a message that it might be spam, but that's fine. Once we set it up to production, it should be good. As you can see, it's showing a sent from Amazon SES. Go ahead and open that email up there and wait for it to load. And there is our spreadsheet, just like before, except this time sent through Amazon. So those are some different ways to export emails inside of Scriptcase that come built in. And in the next video, we're going to look at some custom ways to do it with a little bit of programming if you need some custom work done for the email export.